Right now, we're going to send it down to Natasha Staniszewski and Corey Sarge with tonight's Flames TV postgame show, presented by Original 16.
Original 16, a great way to celebrate things done well.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Flames TV live post-game show, the last post-game of the season, game number 82. Here we are. Corey Sarch joins me to break this one down. The Flames, pretty fun one tonight in front of their fans on Fan Appreciation Night. The goals came fast and furious, and there were a few players looking for some milestones. Most of them got it, and just a fun one, like I said, for the Flames. 5-0 the final here.
Yeah, this one got off to a real quick start for the Calgary mm-hmm. Flames, and they were all over the San Jose Sharks in that first period. They had all the momentum, and we're going to see a few of those highlight reel goals coming up here soon. And it was a fast-flowing game, not to say the least. There was a seven-minute portion in the first period without a whistle. Fans were piled up on the concourse. They couldn't get down. They were all standing there. Their beers were getting warm. So this one, it went by in a breeze. It slowed down a little bit towards the end. We saw a little bit of nasty stuff, but a lot of offense out there tonight.
Yes, we knew the Flames would be getting a lot of shots over to the Sharks net, which they did. So let's show you how some of these pucks went in for the Calgary Flames tonight. This one we didn't really see coming. We were talking about all the other milestones, but Adam Klapka, who got called up earlier this week, he played one game in Vancouver, and this was his second game, and he kind of just gets the puck here in the slot, turns around, gets a couple cracks at it, and with that, he has his first NHL goal.
Yeah, San Jose was kind of, they got a few chances to get a hold of this puck and get it clear, and big long stick here, tries to fire a shot, gets it back, sticks with it, and it's a beautiful shot right over the shoulder of Cooley. That's his first one. He's super excited about it. He thanked his teammates there, thanks Rooney, for a nice screen in front of the net a little bit later, and pretty exciting for the young Czech player.
I thought he might get a Gordie Howe hat trick too because he had that fight, but unfortunately not. Okay, next goal, Blake Coleman, who missed the last four games with an upper body injury. He really wanted to get back into the lineup tonight to try and hit 30, and he did right there.
Yeah, and Ryan Huska said that Coleman had been negotiating with Kent Kubelka, the trainer for the Flames, head trainer, to get into the lineup earlier, and they wanted him to take a specific amount of time off, make sure he did himself right, but he comes back into the lineup and doesn't miss a beat and gets his 30th here tonight.
So a great opening frame for the Flames, and they kept rolling in the third. This time it was Oliver Shillington from the point. I think they're going to set him up there. There it is. Let's it go over Devin Cooley and in. 3-0.
That was a Tim Wakefield special, a big knuckleball from the point.
Yep.
And not sure if Mangiapane got a little piece of this. We saw a picture of him on the bench pointing at his own stick. Shillington was doing hand signals like, no, it just went over your stick and in. So
right.
I think they got it right on this one, but third of the year for Shillington.
Okay, and not long after that, the fourth line back out there, Kevin Rooney this time. We'll get a look from the slot. And here he comes. Fires it. Also goes upstairs there.
Yeah, a lot of goals going in the top corner tonight. And I joked earlier that the Flames had the shooter tutor out in pregame skate this morning, and they were actually lighting it up. And it kind of fell over into the game. But good hustle by Matt Coronato on that goal. He gets a beautiful chance, sticks with it. Couple of passes, and Rooney buries that one.
And before the period was out, another milestone we were keeping an eye out for. Mackenzie Wieger, sitting on 19 goals, was looking for a career-high 20. And there's another one there that kind of just fluttered in high.
Yeah, it's not a great pass here from Miramanov. I know he's just trying to get it quickly over to Wieger because they were trying to find Wieger and Kadri all night. I don't think if that puck isn't rolling, if it's flat, I don't think Wieger, he gets up a flat shot. I don't think it goes in. So it all worked out. And he scored a few like that early in the season, so it's fitting that his 20th goes in with a little wobble on it. But
for sure.
Nice shot in the top corner.
All right, so at this point, things were looking pretty good for Dustin Wolf to finish this one off with a shutout. But unfortunately, you see it right there. The Sharks were on the power play, and Fabian Zetterlund rips one past Wolfie.
Yeah, this is a shot he can't do much about here. Soloviov's trying to get his foot in front of it. I would love him to see just take that lane away early. But again, it's a great shot here. It was maybe a bit of a questionable penalty too. Pospisil was poking at the goalie a little bit there. I don't think he was roughing anybody up. I think they could have evened that one out.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to blame the Stripes for that last one,
too. I totally agree. I didn't see the extra 2 minutes there at all, but nothing we can do about it now. Wolf did have a really good game besides that. He made some really good saves. So we're waiting for some of the Flames to come out in the dressing room. In the meantime, let's talk about some of these milestones. I'm not sure what you can say which is the most important, but Mackenzie Weegar had himself quite a season. He becomes the first player to not only block 200 shots, but also score 20 goals in the same season. A pretty impressive stat. I was asking him about it this morning. He said the block shots, he, of course, remembers them being as very painful, but he was, and he said, his mom was probably going to be watching and hoping to get that 20th goal. He said he wouldn't be thinking about it too much, but I'm sure he's pretty happy to have done it.
Yeah, and you get to hear his interview afterwards, and your teammates remind you
yes.
that you're close to getting and they'll make sure that you've got some money on the board too. So, again, it wasn't a great pass on this goal. But I don't think if that puck's sitting up on the end of his stick, it's a little harder to get through, and this simply fools the goaltender. And good quick release, gets rid of it, and he'll remember that one for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
And it's pretty impressive. Go ahead, Natasha.
No, I just the other thing that we were talking about this morning with him was the way his leadership has come along, and Ryan Huska has really been raving about it the last few months. And I wonder what you think of his potential as a leader on this team.
I think he's one of the guys, I love his attitude in the room. He goes about things the right way. He never really seems to be down. He was one of the most consistent attitudes in that room all year long, and mm-hmm. I think that just reflected in his play, or his play was a byproduct of just him trying to be a great leader and trying to be great for his teammates. So he had himself a heck of a season, and it's something to he'll reflect back on. He learned a lot this year, and he sure grew as a player. That was a very mature season by Mackenzie Weegar.
That's a good way to put it. I like that. A mature season for sure. So that was one milestone. Of course, Blake Coleman was the other one. This is the first time he has reached 30 goals. We said it before, he was itching to get into the lineup. And just another great season by him. Pretty consistent. The goal tonight, probably one of the easiest ones he has scored all year. But a special season for him as well.
Yeah, and they showed a bunch of his stat categories, and everything had gone up. Goals, assists, points. Penalty minutes, time on ice, and I think there was one other category that we jammed in there, but again, his teammates are doing some great work for him here, and nice Connor Zary finds him back door, and it's a tap in. I gotta mention though, he did take the high stick in the face
yes.
to draw the penalty
That's
to get
right.
the goal, so it might not still be the easiest goal he's ever scored.
That's a very good point. That high stick did not look like a fun one, but I guess it, you get the goal and then you don't remember the high stick, right?
I think he'll take it. Yeah, I think he'll take
exactly.
it. No complaints.
That's right. Let's keep going down the list of milestones here. Let's go to Adam Klapka, the 6'8" forward who's on the fourth line. And speaking of potential, I wonder where you think he could go with this team. Big physical guy. He had the fight tonight. He got his first NHL goal. I love seeing players get their first goal. And I guess I'm just curious what you think about him.
Well, he's a big human being. And
yes.
if he learns to use that body and to its full potential. With that reach, with his ability to, if he keeps working on his puck handling, to move pucks around guys with the long reach are the hardest to defend. But he was so generally excited tonight. Whiffs on his first attempt here, gets it back, and it's an absolute laser. And it's a goal that he'll remember for a long time. And Ryan Huska talked about leaving a lasting impression in this last game. Well, he scores a goal, and he's going to get after it here too. He does a good job. It has a nice little scrap here. Shows that he's a willing combatant, and showing his coach that he's ready to be in this game. And we're talking Gordie Howe hat trick here for a little
mm-hmm.
while. You mentioned it earlier,
yep.
and didn't see enough ice time I think tonight to maybe get that next assist. But a great overall effort for Adam Klapka tonight.
And you took the words out of my mouth about last impressions when Ryan Huska was talking about that this morning. And I think, I'm not sure Klapka could have done more tonight to leave a pretty good lasting impression. He has to feel pretty good about the way he finished the season there. Blake Coleman is ready in the dressing room. Let's hear what he had to say after this one.
I'm so happy to hear a Katy Perry song on the Jumbotron there.
it's all kind of a blur right now. I don't even remember the afterthought of it, but yeah, obviously a good way to go out for our team. Good win, a couple guys hitting milestones, so you know, a nice way to end a, you know, what I think of as a tough year.
What does it say when guys are constantly feeding you, Uyghur, Kadri, the puck on a game like this?
It says a lot about our, you know, our room and the guys we have in here. I think we all care about each other, and you know, we want to see each other succeed. And you know, I think at the end of the day, that's what you're most proud of here down the stretch, is guys were playing for each other. And you know, this could have been just a throwaway, meaningless game, and guys took it upon themselves to, you know, to find something to care about, and it was each other. And you know, to me, that goes a long way in the future of this team.
I know the point of the matter, but you guys technically have 38 wins, the same amount as you got last year. Does that mean anything?
I wasn't really aware of it, but no, I mean, obviously, both seasons we missed, and the goal is to go to the playoffs and go on a run. And you know, I think as players, it's tough because this is one of the best cities in the league to get into the postseason. You know, the fans and the city, the way they rally around it, it's one of the most fun things I've been a part of. So I think that's what eats me up, is not getting that opportunity. And you know, but like I said, we have the building blocks and guys who really care and want to be here and want to win in the Flaming Sea. So you know, it's not, you don't want to be looking for silver linings this time of year, but there definitely are some right now.
All right, we're joined on the desk by Rasmus Anderson, and speaking of milestones, you got your 200th point tonight. Pretty fun one, I would guess, for you guys. A good way to finish off the season. Just your thoughts on the game tonight.
Yeah, thank you. But you know, it's not a situation we want to be in. So, but you know, I think we keep coming back to it. We have such a good fan base, and you know, even though we're not in a playoff picture, you still want to perform in front of your fans. And you know, it's they pay to come and watch us. So you kind of want to put on a good show for them. And I thought that's what we did tonight.
So there's a few milestones that were obviously within reach before the start of this game. Dustin Wolf almost gets his first shutout at the end of the game. You hit 200 points tonight with that assist. Were there any side bets before the start of the game? Because it was an absolute shooting gallery out there. Mackenzie Uyghur started, he led the charge. Nazem Kadri, I know we're both looking for their big goal markers, as well as Coleman. Coleman didn't join in, but was there some good kibitzing?
Coleman got us, yeah.
Yeah, but I didn't see as many shot attempts for him out there. Like, was there any kibitzing before?
No.
Were you guys poking fun at each other?
Kind of at the pregame lunch, you know, it was a lot of talk about it. We kind of just said, you know, let the best man win. And but, you know, I'm really happy for Colsey. You know, I think the way he plays, too, makes it extra special for him hitting 30. You know, he's a hard-working player that goes hard in the net, and for him to get 30 goals is unbelievable. And then, you know, for weeks, yeah, as a D-man, it's even more special, I think. And, you know, it's super cool that he got 20 goals, and I couldn't be more proud and excited for both the players. And as you said, it was too bad that, you know, Wolfie didn't get a shutout, and then Nas didn't hit 30, but, you know, Nas have hit it before, so it'll be fine.
Yeah, and it wasn't for lack of effort, that's for sure.
No, right. Exactly. I think it was the entire second period, all I did was look for him. So
we even saw in the third period, guys were looking for him, had a nice move, split the defense, almost put one in, but, yeah, it was a great effort by him tonight.
Yeah, he played good.
Raz, you talked about the 20 goals for Uyghur, but he also had the 200 blocked shots. He had both of those, the first player who's ever done that. Can you speak to just how special that is, how difficult that is?
Yeah, you know, eating pucks, it's never fun and it's never easy. And you know, I think we've done a good job of as a team to block a lot of shots this year. And
right.
You know, obviously he's leading the charge there, and he's really good at it. And just you know, he's in the right position for it to hit him, and you know, willing to block shots too. That's a big part. And you know, with the system we play too, and with the PK system we play, it requires us to block a lot of shots, and he's definitely leading the charge in that.
We were curious, Natasha had mentioned it, Dustin Wolf. He's got a lot of starts as of late. He's played really well in net for you guys. You can see him out there battling, trying to establish himself. How's the communication been between you guys as a D-core with him? How's his comfort level? What do you sense as a defenseman getting to play in front of him?
Yeah, I think he's been good as of late. You know, not super busy tonight, but made some key saves when he had to. And but you know, for the goalie, I just feel like just you know you know how it is. You just leave the goalies alone kind of sometimes, and that's what you got to do. But at the same time, you know, you put a lot of work and effort in it in practices to you know get your calls in with the puck touches and that kind of stuff. Yeah. And but you know, once you're in the game, you know, you try to communicate with him as much as possible, and to just make it easier for him. And you know, he yells at us quite a bit too, that he can't see or to box out or whatever it is. So he's a vocal guy back there too, which you need.
Raz, last one for you. We'll get you out of here. I just wonder your thoughts on this entire season. There were some personnel changes at the end. Obviously, you didn't, you know, reach the goals that you wanted to. What's the biggest takeaway or lesson that you would like this team to take away from this season?
I was actually thinking about it before the game, and I think it's pretty important that you remember this feeling you have now going into next year, and that, you know, even if you have a good year or a bad year or somewhere in between, you know, remember the feeling you have now, because it's never fun being on the outside looking in. And, you know, you got to have that hunger, and, you know, it's a long season. You know, there was a lot of ups and downs, and, you know, got off to a bad start, then we picked it back up a little bit, and, you know, there was a lot of good players moved out of that dressing room. And but I think the young guys that came in did a really good job. And but for next year, it's, you know, they got to take the next step too. And and so does us. I guess older guys who've been here a little longer, we got to take the next step too and keep pushing everyone. And because it sucks to be outside of playoffs. And and that's kind of what you dream about when you're a little kid, to play in those big games. And you know, we're on the outside looking in now, but just remember the feeling, and that we'll be back next year.
Well said. All right. Thanks for your time. Thanks for doing this. And again, congrats on the milestone.
Yeah, thanks. Thank you.
Congrats.
Thank you.
Yeah, so the feeling of not making the playoffs. You look at all the teams who have made the playoffs. It is not easy to get to the postseason, right? And consistency is one thing, one word that's been thrown around a lot this year for this team.
Yeah, and I was just reflecting back on my time with the Calgary Flames. I played here for almost six seasons. One was a half season. But for those first five seasons, we made the playoffs the first 2 years. The next three, we missed. And I looked at our point totals. We had 90 points 1 year, 94, and then 90 again in the third year. And it's just, that's how close it is. Yep. And it's those little things that you do throughout the season. But I completely agree with Rasmus. It's a crappy feeling. Mm-hmm. And this is such a hockey-rich community, great fan base. And you just, it's a lot of pressure. And you want to perform in front of them. You want to give them what they want. And that's postseason action. So I can relate to what he's right. going through.
Okay. Mackenzie Weegar, who scored his 20th goal tonight, is in the dressing room. Let's hear what he had to say. Oh, I'm sorry. Adam Klapka, who scored his first NHL goal. Here he is post-game.
It's hard to keep it straight with all the milestones.
National Hockey League goal. Oh, it's amazing, you know, especially here in Saldon in Calgary. It's amazing, and I never forget about that.
What was tonight like for you?
I mean, you know, it was. I think it was time to show that I can play. And I really appreciate. I'm really happy that I show that I can make a place and play the hard game too. So that's mean a lot for me, and I just gonna try to transfer back to Wranglers and for next year.
Do you know what a Gordie Howe hat trick is?
I know. Yeah, I was close. All the guys was reminding to me, so I was, but I didn't really focus on it. It was just I just want to try to get the Wolfie the shutout and help the team to win.
What was more fun? I'm assuming the goal was a lot more enjoyable than your first fight.
I mean, yeah, of course, you know, all the guys on the show, but I really enjoyed that fight too. You know, it was something, you know, in Saldon when the full and the arena is full, it's amazing.
Did anything in particular lead to the fight, or was it just him trying to spark his team?
No, I mean, be honest, I just asked him on the warm up if he wants to go, because I know he's like, He likes to fight. I really respect it. So I just asked him, and he said, why not? So we just go.
Do you know him from before?
No, I never played against him. That was first time.
So you wanted to get your first NHL fight out of the way, or what made you ask him during warm-up?
I mean, yeah, I just wanted to get him. You know, I think it was the time to do it. You know, it's like both teams are, like, not in the playoffs. So, I mean, I tried to Vancouver, but they didn't want it much. So I just asked him, and he said, yeah.
Who would you ask in Vancouver that said no?
I asked Big Z, but he was like, I understand he didn't want, like, he was at least right before the playoffs, so he was like, no.
Adam, on your goal, the first shot didn't go so well, but you were happy to be able to pull it back in again.
Yeah, I mean, it's, I would say, natural, you know, it just instinct. I just want to try to get it to the net. It doesn't matter how, just get it on the net. Good things happen.
Does it change your summer that you got the first goal, got the first fight? Like, you can go into the summer feeling okay?
Yeah, I mean, of course, you know, you feel like, okay, now I'm able to play here, but it's just a start, you know. It doesn't mean anything for me. I just, like, it's mean for me, but at the same time, doesn't mean anything. You know, you have to still show out you are able to be here and play the NHL hockey. So for me, that's the point. I find out some things what I'm supposed to do better, and I'm going to work on it in the summer.
Adam, given how tonight went, how do you enjoy the rest of your evening here tonight? How do you kind of celebrate on a night your team wins and you have a night you did?
I mean, I'm just going to give a big hug to my girlfriend, and I don't know. I really, you know, we're flying to Abbotsford tomorrow, so it's not really like, we have the game on Saturday, so it's not really like time to celebrate it big. But as soon as I get back, and or we're gonna have after a season, I think we're gonna celebrate with some good dinner.
Adam, any idea who might have been watching back home tonight?
Oh, my dad, 100%. He's gonna wake up for every game if I'm gonna play. So that's him. I didn't check my phone yet, so he's probably gonna be texting me, so I have to call him right now.
Adam Klapka pretty happy after scoring his first NHL goal, as he should be. We have already spoken a ton about Mackenzie Weegar and what he did tonight, but there's one stat that we still didn't get to that you're gonna throw in here.
Yeah, before we hear from him, he joins a pretty neat crew to have scored 20 goals as a defenseman in that Calgary Flames jersey. And it's Gary Suter, Al MacInnis, Dion Phaneuf, and Mark Giordano. And the most impressive part about it, and I guess what sets him a little bit apart, is out of his 20 goals, he had 17 regular season goals. I know he saw some time on the second unit power play a lot this season.
Yep.
A little more on the first unit towards the end of the year, but that's pretty impressive. It's hard to wrap my head around as a former defenseman.
Right.
That many going in that. And when you hear the name, for me, the one that rings is Al MacInnis.
Yes.
28 is a Flame. That's pretty awesome company.
Absolutely. Okay, let's hear from Weegar inside the dressing room.
Did you prepare a speech for your director?
No, I didn't prepare anything. Pretty cool, though. It's pretty special. I was just chatting on the radio with Pat and just said it's one of those things where you look at the end of your career and you can just enjoy a beer and enjoy that record. But in the meantime, I'm here for business, and you know, I want this team to go in the right direction. And you know, we'll talk about this, I'm sure, tomorrow, and after that we'll be talking about next year. So I'm looking forward to talking about next year for sure.
How cool is it to have your name beat a record for a guy who's got a banner up here at the Saddle Dome in Al MacInnis?
Yeah, that's special. That's pretty cool. It's an honor, you know, to break one of his records. Obviously a hell of a player. He was pretty important to this city, and I'm sure there's a lot of fans out there that still love that guy, and pretty cool. I haven't really decompressed it all right now, but yeah, it's pretty cool. It's pretty awesome, special feeling.
Tough season for sure, and you'll break it down tomorrow, as you said. Mm-hmm. Just on a night where there was a lot to like, mm-hmm. How special was tonight, given everything? I know it's not the ending you wanted, but the way you went out as a group and style.
Yeah, I think the most special part was the big mutant Klapka getting that goal and giving me a big hug, and he's looking down at me, and I scored in the NHL, and he's spitting on my face. And spitting on my face. I just scored in the NHL, and I'm like, fucking right. So, you know, it's little things like that are special, and you don't forget those. I'm happy for him. He's worked hard to get to where he is. He's going to be a great player in this league. I'm going to be biting my teeth over that Wolfie, that last goal. I'm sure he's going to be fine. He'll be fine. He'll get a shutout, but that would have been another nice touch. And then I just wanted to shout out to the poor girl that I hit with the puck in the face in the corner. I don't know if you guys saw it, but I gave her my stick, the 20th goal. it means anything to her, that stick. So I hope she's doing okay. I felt really bad, so I hope she's doing all right.
What does it say about this group, Mackenzie, the fact that your teammates were feeding you and Kadri and Coleman the puck all night? What does it say about the bond that you meant?
Yeah, it just shows you what kind of the kind of guys and the kind of character we have in this room, how much we care for one another. I wish we talked less about all those goals before the game, because I couldn't get out of my head before my nap. but you know, that's what I'm most proud of, is just how much we cared for tonight and for one another. And you know, after I scored, just the sincerity of, you know, the congratulations from everybody, and you know, the congrats, you know, everybody's fist pumping you and all that. But then when they come up to you after and they say, you know, how proud they are of you and the little things like that, it goes a long way for me. So it gives me goosebumps, and you know, I love all these guys in this room. So it's awesome. We've got a great group.
Are you able to say how much money was on the board for all that?
Yeah, there was no money because we didn't hit the milestones yet. So when we return here next year, I'm sure there'll be. Ras won't forget it. He's the fine master. So, he'll make us. I mean, he got his 200th point too. So that's something that's pretty special as well. He'll be up on the board next year, first game. So we won't let him forget about it either.
All right, thanks.
Original 16, a great way to celebrate things done well.
So the Flames wrap up their season with a 5-0 win over the Sharks, and we have said the word milestone about 100 times tonight. One guy who did not reach the milestone, unfortunately, that he was looking for was Nazem Kadri, and not for lack of trying. He was sitting on 29 goals. A ton of great chances for him tonight, but just couldn't find one.
Yeah, and he'll be kicking himself on the one that we're going to see here that is partway through the first period. But he finished the game with, what was it, 16 shot attempts.
8
that registered on the net. There's the one we're talking about there.
Probably Devin Cooley robs him.
It might be Cooley's only save of the night, too. It happened to be on Nazem Kadri. But you know, he had, like I said, he split the defense tonight and danced in. He had some shots. He had some touches around the net that were close. This was after they pulled Cooley and put in Romanov. He went right to work getting some shots on him.
Yep.
Great move there. Just won't quite sit for him, so he can put that where he wants to. But Nazem Kadri, probably the Flames' most consistent player this year. If you had to pick an MVP on that team, he would be one of probably two or three names that would be mentioned. The only real blip in his play this year was at the start of the year. He might have started a little slower than he wanted, but so consistent throughout the year, really played as a team player, and I got to give him a lot of credit. Like, he played with tons of different players this year.
Yes.
He got those young guys going, like Zari and Pospisil. Near the end, we saw him with Kuzmenko at times, and so he just never kind of missed a beat, never complained about it. He just went about his business this year. And again, I'm not sure, 70-some points, I wish I knew the number, the total exactly. That's really impressive. 75 points, another great season by Nazem Kadri.
He did really seem to embrace that leadership role. I'm not sure we've seen that from him like the way he was before, but you're right, playing with all those different players. Huska mentioned it multiple times when asked about Kadri. In the same way that we saw it from Uyghur, you wonder if this is sort of a different new role, identity that these guys are taking on.
It happens to you. Yeah, another mature season by Nazem Kadri. Yeah, I remember my very last season was Nate McKinnon's rookie year, and I'm like, oh boy, I'm the 35-year-old. I got this 18-year-old kid. Couldn't teach him a whole heck of a lot, being a defenseman and him a forward. But you do. It just generally happens to you. You get into your late 20s, your 30s. You've been in every situation, and you want to relay that to the young kids. And if you want to be a competitive team, well, you got to help them to get to a certain point so that your team can flourish. And I thought just Nazem did a great job of that all year long with all of his line mates.
Right. And okay, Ryan Huska is speaking to the media. Let's hear his thoughts on the final game and the end of the season.
What does it say about this group and maybe the bond these men have, the fact that they were constantly feeding, whether it was Uyghur, Kadri, and others the puck, that Coleman, that had these milestones in reach?
Yeah, I think for me, it says a lot about teammates, for sure. That's one thing you take out of it. But I'm more pleased the way we played tonight. The game mattered to them, and it wasn't just to help guys get milestones. So I think they wanted to leave each other with a good last impression, and to me, they did that tonight.
What did you think of how Adam Klapka played tonight?
I thought Adam played well. I thought that line played well. Adam, Maddie, and Runes, I thought they all three of them did some good things tonight. It's nice to see the big guy score a goal, of course, and getting himself involved physically is, it just shows the type of player he is. He's not afraid. He'll play hard, and I think that was a good sign for us.
On Adam and Ilya, have you seen a difference in them this time around than when you saw them earlier on in the season with call-ups?
Adam, very much so. Ilya, he was quite early in the year last time we saw him, and I do think there is a difference in his game as well, maybe more so with Adam. The last time Adam came up, he was trying to play with the puck a lot through the neutral zone, and he turned over pucks a lot, and he shifted that. So now it was all about when I got myself to a position, it was going in, and I was going to forecheck hard, and he was going to play in the offensive zone. So he was one for sure that was a different player.
I don't want this to come across as flippant at all. You've talked so much about, leaving final impressions. Is there value in this team? Just they all talked about actually having fun out there, and just the final impression being them having a good time on the ice as a group.
Well, you play a game. Games are supposed to be fun. I think there's stretches of the season that are hard when the team isn't getting results, and it's not enjoyable, because that's what we're here to do is find results. But the guys have to enjoy being around each other. That's the most important thing. So when they come to the rink, they want to be there. Way easier when you're winning games. There's no doubt about that. But it is a game, and they have to enjoy what they're doing every night. So we want to see that. I think that's an important part of culture.
Ryan, for McKenzie to be the first player in this league to get 20 goals and 200 block shots in a season, what does that tell you about what he accomplished this year?
I didn't know that until I heard it from these guys tonight. That is quite the stat, actually, now. The shot blocking to me is more important. Well, not more important, but that's the one where that's the hard part of the game, where over and over you're doing it again when you're not feeling good, and you put yourself in those positions and you continually play through it. When you look at McKenzie, you'd have to say he was one of our more consistent players this year. So I thought he did a really good job leadership-wise, offense from the back end from us. But then you have the intangibles that he brings. Like, he's a competitor, he's physical, and he'll put his body on the line to help a team win. And that's the type of player you want to have.
Dustin and Matt are heading back to the AHL after being up here for quite a while. Can an extended run like this give them some confidence heading back to the AHL and into their postseason?
They should have confidence now. I mean, they've done great things in the American League before. What we need of them is to go and be impact players and to help the team win. So it's not just going down there and being a body that's going to be put on the ice. They have to take this as an opportunity to be difference makers when they step on the ice, because that's what the Wranglers need them to be. And long term, that's what we need of them. So this is an opportunity for them to continue to get better and help our team win.
Just to that point, you've been a coach in the American Hockey League. What kind of value can those guys get from a postseason run with the Wranglers that can help the Flames eventually?
Other than the Stanley Cup playoffs and playing games that matter as you come towards the end of the season, it's the next best thing. So when you have young guys that are in those situations, there's a heightened level of pressure, of course. Every play in a game matters. You learn quickly what the difference is between winning and losing. So it's a valuable thing, and it's a great thing that team was able to make the playoffs. Okay, thank you, guys.
All right, there's the coach with his last post-game comments of this season. I'm sure he's done with all the questions.
I think so.
Let's sort of sum up this season for the Flames. Like I mentioned before, some personnel changes, a little bit of inconsistencies for this team. Ultimately, they don't make the playoffs. But the future looks bright with some of the players they've acquired and some of the players taking on this leadership role that we just spoke of. What are your thoughts on this team and where they're at?
Yeah, again, it's just, I think for next year, the goal has got to be to add some more consistency. If you take a look at their 82-game schedule, there's a lot of those kind of streaks in there. Some good, where you got on a 3 or 4-game win streak,
right,
but you can't turn around and go on a 3 or 4-game losing streak. It's got to have just a little less of those major ups and downs. Mm-hmm. You got to find a way to just, again, it's always about more wins. That's easy. But you've got some guys in here that are going to be fighting for jobs. You're going to have probably a very hungry training camp next year. I know that these guys don't get to beat the tar out of each other like they used to in the olden days at training camp, but it'll be ultra competitive. And you know what? It's going to be a fun summer for me. Yeah, keeping my eye on Craig Conroy and what they're doing with the draft, what they're doing as far as movement. And then, again, there's a lot of faces that we see in this dressing room today that may or may not be here. So it's going to be another very busy offseason for the Calgary Flames.
And we are looking forward to it. Okay, that's it for us here at the Flames TV desk. Thank you for tuning in tonight. And for all season long, the Flames finish up the season with a dominating 5-0 win over the San Jose Sharks. We will see you back here next year.